In this video, I want to introduce what is considered to be an abstract concept. That's the concept of vector space. Vector spaces can be made of many different objects, including functions. But in this course on matrix algebra, we're really going to concentrate on vectors that are column matrices. But I want to be a little bit more general, so let's first define what a vector space is. So a vector space consists of two things. One is a set of vectors, in this course the vectors will be simply column matrices. But as I mentioned, vectors can be more general than just column matrices. And in addition to the set of vectors, you need a set of scalars. In this course, the scalars will simply be the set of real numbers. Typically, the set of scalars can be also the set of complex numbers, but we won't deal with that in this course. So a vector space consists of a set of vectors. Could be an infinite set and is likely to be an infinite set, and a set of scalars, such as the real numbers, that has a certain property, which is that it's closed, well, that's the key, closed under vector addition. And scalar multiplication. Okay, what's the meaning of closed? It means that if you have two vectors in your vector space and you multiply them by scalars, and then add them, the final result is also a vector, and it has to be a member of your vector space. So starting with a set of vectors that form your vector space, you can multiply them by scalars and add them, and you don't leave that set of vectors. Okay, you stay in that set of vectors. That's the meaning of closed. So we can look at an example of that. So what is an example of a vector space? Okay. So we need a set of vectors and a set of scalars. So the set of vectors will be all 3 by 1 matrices, right? Those are what we called column vectors before, or column matrices. So they have 3 rows and 1 column. So that's our set of vectors. And the set of scalars are just the real numbers, right? I claim that that's a vector space. My claim that this is a vector space means that if we take any 3 by 1 matrix, multiply it by a real number, and add it to any other 3 by 1 matrix, multiply that by a real number, and do we end up with a 3 by 1 matrix? We do, right? So if in this case, if U and V are 3 by 1 matrices, and we take W equals a scalar, a real number, times U, plus a real number times V, then is W a 3 by 1 matrix? Yes, right? So W is a 3 by 1 matrix. Okay? We can illustrate that as explicit as you want, right? So that's basically saying if if we have A times a 3x1 matrix, x1, x2, x3, right? Plus B times another 3x1 matrix, y1, y2, y3. If we do this, then A just multiplies all the components of this matrix. B multiplies all these components. We add them. We get AX1 plus BY1, AX2 plus BY2, AX3 plus BY3. Is this a 3x1 matrix? Yes, it is, right? So this is a vector space. In this course, our interest in vector spaces is because we're going to be looking at a matrix from the angle of what are the vector spaces associated with that matrix, okay? So we're going to be talking about vector spaces associated with matrices. And that will go by the name of something like a null space. That will be a vector space. A column space. A row space. Okay? And one more vector space, which will be called the left null space. Okay, that's what we'll be talking about in this module of the course. What are the key vector spaces associated with matrices? I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.